it's just amazing to me that in 100 and celebrating Baldwin, that we still have these particular struggles in life. I just wanted to comment very briefly again on, these are my notes here that I've taken. When he talk about the suffering, I'm not sure if there's any different in the suffering that African Americans did in the 1960s as opposed to now, given the three evils of poverty, ignorance, and economically disadvantaged to the nth degree. And so I think that we do have opportunities to mitigate the suffering through mental health services, but right here in Maryland, where we have our first Black governor, Wes Moore, he have yet to provide critical, affordable mental health access to care. He will say that he's doing it. He's not doing it, because you can go throughout the Black community and you cannot find clinical psychologist to talk to on a readily taught basis. There's a lot of hoops that one would have to go through to get those services. And of course, that is the crisis that we face in the Black community. So suffering has not been alleviated in any massive ways in recent times. So Baldwin also talked about the fact of anger. I certainly believe, and many of my colleagues in the ministry believe, that we are dealing with more anger now than ever before. It has not changed. And people are angry about everything. And racism is just compound the anger, the human anger that one would normally go through, but racism will compound that. And so when he talk about go tell it on the mountain or the fire next time, well, the fire has already happened. We saw the fire blowing up in George Floyd situation. We've seen the fire all through COVID. And depending upon who wins this election, we may see some more fire. There are many Americans who predict that this society is on its last leg. I personally don't believe that. I think that there is hope in the society, but it refuses to do the right thing. This society does not care about the poor. Let's be very clear about that. If you poor and you lack education and you lack the motivation and you suffer from any type of isms, poorism, if that's a word, racism, you are going to die early. And society is comfortable with that. The Black church is not, and that's why we are fighting tooth and nail.